Okay, so in this video, we'll be seeing third lab program, which is to design a basic signup and login page. So here it takes a username and password as two parameters, and it will register a user. So one can do login by using the same credentials. So let's see the demo. Okay, so this is the app design which will get. So here you can enter the username, and then you can give a password. And you can sign up. So here, if you enter the same username and password, so you will get a success message over here. Now, if I try to log in with an invalid password, so then I will get an invalid message. So if I do it continuously for 3 times, then as you can see, so too many unsuccessful attempt, and the sign in button has been disabled. So if you give your password wrong for more than 3 times, then your sign in button should get disabled. And also, like while signing up, you have to make the password such that it is having one capital letter and also one special character and also containing one number, and its minimum length should be 8. So if I do not match that criteria, so then basically I should get a message like invalid password. So this is what we'll be building in this video. So you can start a new project by clicking on empty activity, and here you can give the name as login, and just click on finish. Okay, so once the project has been set up, so you can just open the activity main. So we'll start with designing a sign up page first, and then we'll move on to the coding of the coding part of it. So let me just clear this out. Right, so now we have got the blank layout. So here what you can do is, so you can go to text, and here you can get the plain text and just drag it here. Okay, so here they have mentioned us to use the constraint layout. So basically open activity main and add the constraint layout. So so if you open the component tree, here you can get the constraint layout, and here you will see an error. Like if you click on the declared attributes, sorry, on the layouts, so here you can see the error, not horizontally constrained or not vertically constrained. So basically we have not added any constraint to this. So we'll first add the constraint. So how you can add is basically you can either do this, you can click on this plus mark on either side, or you can just, okay, so let me reload it. So you can just take this side and you can just drag the arrow over here. Similarly, you can just take this point and you can just drag the arrow like this, and also from bottom and also from the top. Right. So now you have added constraints on all the 4 sides. So now you can position this this field anywhere. Similar thing we have to do it with password. So take it and just add the constraint like this, drag it here. And also to this side, and also to the top, and also to the bottom. Right. So just position it right there. Okay, so now just add a button. So same thing can be done with this also. Just let us add a plain text over here. So not the plain text, so just a normal text view. So where you can give it setting as this is the sign page, and do the same thing with this also. Okay, so now let's go to the code and change the text over here. Okay, so let's first click on this, and you can change it to, so instead of text you can use something called as hint. So it basically gives like what field has to be entered over there. So you can remove this handle text, and then in the password you can again you can just give a hint like what has to be entered. So it's basically password. And button, so you can change this text to sign up, and this text view can be changed to sign up page. And also let me increase the font size. And let me give it a color of white. Okay, so right. And now what we have to do is, so basically you have to use these buttons in your code. So that's why you need to specify an ID to this thing, all the fields which we are using. So basically we will be using this username. So you can go to this ID, and here you can change its ID to username, and just give refactor, and also to the password you can give it as password. And if you see the it has been changed, and also to this button you can give it as sign. So now these three fields have been added. So if you go to the code here, you can see Android has been added to username and password has been added as password. And yeah, so now we have added this IDs to the fields which we want. So now it's been added to username and password has been added as password. And yeah, so now we have added this IDs to the fields which we want. So now, so next we have to create the login page. So what they have told, so you have to create one more empty activity called as login activity, and we need to design this part. So to do that, you can go to the project, and here in the Java you can go to this first folder that is login, and if you just right click on that you can see this, you can go to this new, and here you can see something called as activity. So in this activity you need to choose empty activity. So this is nothing but in the, so when you are setting up the project in the beginning you will get something like basic activity, empty activity, and you will choose empty activity. So right, so that's the same thing. We will be needing a new empty activity. So here you can name it as sign in, so which will be the second activity, and a new activity has been created. So here if you see, if you go to your res folder and into the layout, you can see there are two activities which are created, and also in the Java you can see in the first folder you can see two main activities has been created, sign in and main activity. So now we have completed this part. Similarly we need to complete the sign in part also. So let's quickly do that. Okay, so now I have created this sign in page. So here you can, so I have given the ID and so here I have specified the ID and I have specified the constraints. So let's start working on the backend. So first we need to create the sign up page. So yeah, so let us open this main activity, and here you can start the coding part. So here, so okay, so here you can see set content view r.layout is basically given to the activity main. So like whenever the app loads, then this activity main will be the first layout which will be shown on the screen. So yeah, so first let us create the objects for these three fields. So that is basically we are having this edit text, two edit text and a button. So let's create the object for that. So we'll take like edit text, and here basically we will take the username, and then you are having a password, and then there is button. Let us give it as sign up button. So those are basically objects. So here you can just do alt and enter. So package will be imported there, and similarly for the button. Right. So now we have created two objects. So now what you need to do is, so basically whenever the app gets loaded, so this onCreate function is called, and at that time what should happen is, so basically these, from these two fields you need to get the information, right? So first of all we need to identify these fields in the backend. So what you need to do is, you need to do something like find view by ID. You need to use the R, and in that you have to use ID. And so basically first of all you need the username, so you can just click on get the username. So find view by ID username, and then you need to assign this to the object which you have created, so which is basically this. So here you will take a username and you will just attach it to that, and then similarly you have to do it for the password also. After initializing these objects with the IDs or the elements, so next you need to add a onclick listener to that. So basically, so whenever I click on the sign up button, so whatever I have written in these two fields, I should first get those things, right? So here you need to add a listener onto sign up button. So basically whenever I click on the sign up button, so it should take me to the next page. So what should I do is, I will take the sign up button, and to that I will add this set on click listener function to that. So basically this function takes in the view. So what we have to do is, so inside this we need to pass something like, you have to create name, and then we need to give like view on click listener. So if you click on this, so you can get this method. So if you go to onClickListener, and here you can see onClickListener is basically an interface, and it is having a method called wideOnClick. So since it is in the interface, so we need to implement this method. So here you can see there is no definition to this method, right? So we need to tell like onClick of that button what should happen. So here what should happen is, basically it has to move to the next page, correct? So it has to move to the sign page. So to do that, so what we'll do is, first we'll take these two parameters inside, and then we'll just do sign up. So to get those two parameters, so you can just declare a string like uname, and you can take the username object which you had created, and you can do like get text, right? So okay, so here you can see there is an error, so it's because you have not converted it to string. And similarly you need to do the same thing for password, and from the password object you need to get the text, and you need to convert it to the string, right? So now basically whatever I have entered is stored in uname and this pwd, right? Okay. Okay, so next I need to move from this main activity to this sign in activity page, correct? So in order to do that, so in Android there is something called as intent. So basically intent is class. So this class is basically having a lot of methods. So first of all I will take this intent, and I will create an object of the intent type, and I will create a new object. Okay, so now in the intent, so there is a function called, okay, so it's difficult to find here. Okay, so let me just edit, right? Okay, so here in the intent, so there is something called source, and there's a function which takes two parameters, source and destination, right? So now what I want, so I am in this main activity, so that is my source, and now I want to move to the sign in activity, right? So that will be my destination. So I should pass in the inside, in the intent, I should pass this main activity which is my source, and I want to move to the sign in activity. So I will pass the sign in. So basically you have to specify like this object. So here you will give main activity dot this, and I need to move it to the sign in class. So I will give it like sign in class. Okay, so right, so now you have created this intent object, and you have initialized that with the source and the destination. So now I need to start the activity. So basically I should give like start activity, and inside that I need to pass the intent object.
Okay,
so now, so what happens is, so whenever I click on the sign up button, so basically I can move from the main activity to the sign in activity. So let's just run this app and see. Okay, so after installing the app, okay, so you can see the sign up page. So if I click on this sign up, so it is moving to the next page. So here we have not done anything with the name and the password, so we will see that now. Okay, so you are getting the password and the username from here, and then they have mentioned that you need to validate the password with this regular expression, right? So first of all, we have to add this validation function in the code. Okay, so let's do that. Right, so you can do something like, so after getting this password from the user, so here you can add a if condition. Like, okay, so before that, so yeah, okay, so here you can add a if condition, so in which you can create a new function called as validate password, right? So and in the parameters you can pass the password which you have created. So now you have not created this function, so you can create this function. So you need to create this function outside this onCreate. So yeah, so here you can create the function called as validate password, which will take in password as its parameter. It will take a string as its parameter, and it will return a boolean, and it should be public, right? So now we have to add the definition to this validate password. Okay, so here they have given this regular expression, so I will copy this regular expression and I will assign it to a variable. Let it be a string, so it will be a, I will give it like regular expression, and yeah, so this is the regular expression. And okay, so now if your password doesn't matches if it doesn't matches this characteristics, so then it's not valid. For example, so here you can see there should be a capital character, and there should be the special character, and the length of the password should be a minimum of 8, right? Okay, so this is a regular expression variable which we have defined. Right, so in the validate password, what you need to do is, so basically there is something called as pattern, and pattern will basically help us to instead of doing it manually, like writing long code for that, you can just use something called as pattern.compile, and here inside this you can specify the regular expression which you have declared over here. So basically now I want to get my password validated with this regular expression, so I will pass this regular expression in the compile, and here I will create a new variable of the type pattern, and I will assign the its compiled value to this. And then what I will do is, I will compare the password which I have written, which I have obtained from this part, and to the this compiled regular expression. Now you have to match your password which you have obtained from the user with the regular expression. So you can just take the pattern object, and there is a method called as matcher. So inside that you can pass the password which you have with the user as entered, and it will return you a value which is of the type matcher, and you can create a new variable matcher, and here you have to import this class, right? And then so since it's a boolean value, so you have to return either true or false. So basically you have to take the matcher object, and then you have to return matches or not, right? So basically it will return either true or false. So it is basically passed to this if, and if it is true, then it should enter, and it should move on to the next activity, right? Right, so it should move on to the next intent, or else it should give a message like unsuccessful login. So in order to give a message, so you can use something called as toast. So if you just type in toast, and you can if you press control and then spacebar, then you will get this predefined statement over here, right? So what will it say? So it basically says, so toast is basically a class, so there is a method called as make text. So where it should make text, so in the present activity itself, so in the main activity itself, and here you can specify the text. So you can give like something called invalid password, or yeah, so this is basically the custom text which you will provide. And here basically toast, you can see the length as short, so basically it will remain only for a few seconds. So if you want to change it, and you can make it like length long, right? Okay, so basically what it does is it will make the message to remain on the screen for a longer period of time. So yeah, so now okay, so now let's just run the app and see. Okay, so after running this app, and if I type the username, so it will be user, and password I will give it as abcd and 1 2 3 4 4. So if I sign up, so yeah, you can see it is going to the next page. And if I give incorrect password, like if I give the password which is of only 3, then you can just see invalid password. So yeah, so we have completed the sign up page, and now let's start working on the sign in page. Okay, so in the sign in page, what you have to do is, so basically you need to get the sign up details, like you need to get the username and password which you had entered in the main activity, and you have to compare it with what user will enter. So if it will match, then there is a successful login, or then if it doesn't match, then you should give like a login as failed. So basically now you need to store this information somewhere. So right, so okay, so here you will be, okay, so here you will be entering this information, right? User and username and password. So basically you have to store it somewhere, and then that you have to compare it with the details which you will enter in the sign in page. So to do that, in the main activity itself, you need to use something called as bundle. So first of all, you need to create an object of the type bundle, and right, so bundle is basically a class, so which will be having which is having several methods. So and it is basically used to transfer the data from one page to another. So here what I will do is, so since I want to transfer this username and password from this main activity to the sign in activity, right? So basically to do that, create something like bundle, and then you can do something, you can create a new key value pair. So you can do something like bundle dot put string, and here, so put string is basically a method, so which will basically take a key value pair. So it will basically take a key, and then it will take a value. So here what value you want to send, so first you need to send this username, that is uname, and for this I will give a key as a username, and next I need to transfer this password also. So I can just give like password is the name of the key, and the value which I want to transfer is basically this pwd. Okay, so now I have assigned the key value pair, so if I type in username, so then I will get the username which the user has entered. And then for the password also, if I give like this password, then I will get the value which is stored in this variable. Now I have to move this data from this page to same page, right? So for moving the move for moving from one page to another, we had created this object called intent. So apart from this, what we can do is with the help of intent. Okay, so let's just bring this up here. And yeah, so we have created this object. So before starting the activity, so here what you can do is you can take the intent object, and it is having a method called put extra. So you have to, yeah, so put extras. So basically if you click on this, so put extras will basically take a bundle. So here you have created this bundle, right? So that thing you need to pass here. Okay, so now whenever it moves to the next page, so it will basically transfer this data to the intent. So in the sign in, so you can access the bundle which you had created in the main activity and transfer it over here. So yeah, so now let's go to the sign in page and let's see how we can use the bundle data over there. Okay, so now in the sign in page, what you have to do is, so basically you have to do the same thing which you have did with the main activity. So first of all, you need to create the objects for this object for the design which you have created. So basically for this and this, so you need to create the objects for those, and you can use them. So here, so instead of sign up, I will give sign in. And also yeah, so you need to do this. So you need to find it by ID whenever it loads, and here you can give sign in, right? So after this, what you have to do is, so if you go to the design, so basically first you need to, okay, so now you need to add a listener to this sign in button, so that I can get this, I can fetch this username and password and compare it with the previous value. So before that, so here we had used this bundle to transfer the data, right? So first let us fetch that transfer data. So what you can do is, so you can use something called as from the intent. So basically you have passed the intent, right? So first of all, get the, there's a method called as get intent. So yeah, from that so basically you had used something like here, like you have used intent dot put extra. So here from that intent only, so you need to get the extras which you had passed, right? So there is something called get extras. So basically whatever you had passed in the intent, so you can get its value. So and it will return you so basically, right, basically like here you had passed the bundle object, right? So basically it will return you the same thing. So you need to create a new bundle object, and yeah, so we have created a new bundle object, and you have assigned the return values to that. And so here you had given the key value pairs, right? So now if I use the key as username, so then I will get the entered details, so the details which I had entered in the sign up page. So you need to just give like bundle dot there is something called get string. So get string will basically take a key. So here you want the username value, so you will pass the key as username which you had declared previously. So you have got that. And for the password, you will do like get string, and inside that you will pass the password as its key. Okay, so now you have got this, but you have to assign it to something. So here I am creating a new variable called as uname, and here I am creating a new variable called as pwd. So yeah, so basically these two variable contains the value from the sign up page, right? So that has been done. So next, what you need to do, so now whenever the user clicks on this sign in button, so it should basically validate this entered information with the previous information, and it should either give the success message or the failure message. Right, so now let's take the button object and add a event listener onto that. So on click, what should happen is basically again the same thing. So you need to fetch the, you need to get this value, right? So you need to basically get this value and you need to compare it with this. So here I will change the variable name. I will give it as user and I will give it as password. Okay, so this is basically from whatever the user has entered, I'm getting it from there. And here you need to add a check condition. So if the entered user is basically equals to equal, so here what happens is, so if you give like this double equals to symbol, so what happens is basically this comparison operator will compare the values which are present in this. Along with that, it will also compare its memory location. So basically it lies in some other memory location and it lies in some other memory location, right? So basically they will not match. So instead of using this, you can use something called as equals, and inside that you can pass the uname. So this uname is basically the previous one which you had obtained from main activity, and this user is basically from this sign in which the user has entered. So if this and the password, so pass dot equals, you have to compare it with the password. So if this two condition satisfies, then you have to display the message of success. So again here you can use the toast and control and spacebar, so you can get this. And here you will give the message as successful, and then if it fails, you can give the message like unsuccessful. So here you can give like fail, right? So now let's just try running our app. Okay, so I installed the app on the phone. So here you need to give the username and give it as user and password as abcd at 1234, and here also I'll give the same username and the password 1234. Yeah, so here you can see it has successfully logged. So if I try to send the password, and you can get the fail message. So yeah, so this was the main part, and apart from this, so you have to do one more feature. So basically if I do the, if I will get, okay, so if I get the failure message for more than 3 times, or if I fail to log in continuously for more than 3 times, then I should disable the sign in button. So that can be done. So basically, yeah, so here you can just declare a new variable called as count, and you can keep track of it over here. So if the login fails, so here you can increment the counter. And here what you can do is, so you can make the if condition. So if the count will be equals to equals to, or the count is greater than or equals to 3, then you can take like, you can make the sign button as invalid. So to do that, you can take the sign button, and there is something called set enabled. So here you can pass in false. So or else you can declare this toast message. Okay, so now let's try doing that. Okay, so now, so let me just type in the username. also. So here if I fail to do that, so let me just try it again and see. So here you can see the sign in button has been disabled and you cannot log in. So yeah, so this was the third lab program.